Yeah, so the only reason why goodwill will exist is because what did the scenario say, additional information? What does the owner want to do?
Wanted to do, add a partner.
Exactly. So if he's adding a partner to an existing business, does the existing business have goodwill?
Yeah.
Probably. Okay, because the business has been operating for however long. Okay. Alright, that's the first part, defining that. So you've got intangible asset, that's important. I would also talk about the admission or admitting a new partner. A new partner. Okay, but if I admit a new partner, what's going to happen? We need to value the business. Value the existing business. Comma, goodwill will arise when a new partner is paying for a share of the business. Right, so obviously this individual, I think it's Shane, hey?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so Shane's been operating for some time now. Shane wants to expand. Shane wants to bring in a new partner. Obviously the partner's going to have to pay a price to be part of this partnership. Right, he's not going to join the business without incurring a certain, let's say, cost. Right, the cost of joining the business. Because the business is obviously established. The business must be doing quite well if someone else wants to buy a part of the business. And that's how goodwill is created. And that's what they describe here. The textbook definition is, goodwill is the cost of acquiring a business less the total value of the assets and liabilities that have been purchased. So if you're buying a business that's priced at a higher price than what the assets and liabilities are worth, that's obviously a good thing for the owner that's selling the business, okay, or selling part of the business. What else can you remember about goodwill? They also said about the valuation, eh? See, two reasons how it may arise. So the first reason, buying a share of the business. We spoke about that. Another reason would be change in ownership. Change in ownership, brackets, when the partnership changes. Right, any change. It can be if a partner leaves, it can be if a partner joins, it can be a partner if a partner retires. As long as there's a change. Whenever you value assets and liabilities, you can have goodwill.
Okay.
Right, so those are the two points. What else did they say? Explain the meaning. Okay, so we've got goodwill. I think we've done that. Suggest two reasons why it may arise. I think you've actually covered it. Is there anything here that we could maybe mention? Let's see. Yeah, we spoke about the change. If you want to, you can maybe talk about the valuation, but I think that's additional. You can just say asterisk valuation of goodwill. See page. That's if you want to add a bit more detail. 209. Okay, let's carry on. D.
He says explain how goodwill should be treated in the books of a partnership.
Yeah, that's a nice easy one. You already spoke about it earlier.
What do they mean by treated in the books of a partnership?
So,
I don't really understand how they worded it.
Okay, so how are you going to treat water and electricity in your business? Yes. Okay. So, yeah, the treatment is what are you going to do with it? So, are you going to put it as an asset, liability, capital, drawings, income, expense? Like, what is it to the business? How is it going to be like treated? Treated as in, recorded,
so
recorded or recognized?
An asset. Eh?
What asset? There's two types of assets.
I don't know.
Non-current assets. Why? It's long-term. It's generated over time. You don't have goodwill at the beginning. You have goodwill over time. Okay. Right, so it'll be recorded on the debit side of the asset account. Okay, so non-current asset, you know what it is, it's a long-term asset. It'll have a debit balance. Goodwill will have a debit balance and disclosed in the statement of financial position, because that's where you show assets and liabilities. Okay, that's for 3 marks, that should be good enough, or 4 marks. statement of financial position. Right, so we know it's a non-current asset, we know assets go to the debit side, we know the statement of financial position discloses those assets.
Sorry.
Yeah, and that's it, that's about it. So there's not much more you can say there. If you want to, again, you can talk a little bit about the valuation. You can just say goodwill will be valued, valued when a change in ownership arises. All right, that's another maybe treatment bit. So just to have 4 points. Now, I tend to use mark allocation a lot. If I was answering these questions, that would be my first thing. How much marks do I get? And then describe it as best as possible. Okay, bringing in as much as possible in line with the mark allocation. Okay. All right, so that wraps up that question. Let's see. New question, slightly different topic. Now we're looking at a bit more management accounting. Question 3.
Okay. Ali Limited manufactures one product. The following information is available for the production of one unit of product for year ended 30th of June 2014.
Okay, so you know this is internal records. Hey? This is more detailed accounting. This would be the management stuff. So that would have been those chapters toward the end, these red chapters, not the purple. The purple is financial accounting. The red is management accounting. All right, so that's fine. We understand that. Then they obviously give you selling price, materials, labor, etc. Question number 1.
Following information is available for the production of one unit of product for the year ended.
Yes.
So it's just per unit, is that
yes.
What
you mean? Yes.
I'm just asking.
Per one unit, correct. Right, okay. So first question.
Okay, calculate the break-even point.
Okay, do we know what BEP equals?
I forgot.
Fixed costs divided by selling price minus variable cost, okay, which is called the contribution. This is actually similar to the example in your final assignment. In assignment 6, the one that I did for you that I sent, you have a BEP question there as well. Okay, so you just revise the formula, you write it down, and then you work it out. This is out of 5. Okay, so what information do I have in the question? Well, let's go back and have a look. You're obviously in the exam, you wouldn't want to write BEP. You'd write up the whole thing, but because we're practicing, we can just write the acronym. Okay, so
variable costs, that's
what VC is. Yes, looking at the question, okay, they've given you the selling price, that's good. I want fixed costs though. Do we have any fixed costs there? Yes, we do.
Where? Fixed factory overheads.
There's one, what else?
Fixed selling and administration.
Good, there's 2. Okay, so fixed cost needs to be the total fixed costs. So the fixed factory overheads was $5. How many goods are we selling? 18,000 budgeted output. 18,000 units per year times 18,000. Okay, plus, that's the one part. Plus the second part, what else do we have? Fixed selling and admin expenses, 3.5 times 18,000 units. This is the total fixed costs divided by open brackets. Selling price per unit, we have that, 32 Rand, dollars, minus. Then we need variable cost per unit. Okay, is direct material variable cost?
Pardon?
Is direct material variable cost?
I can't remember variable costs and everything.
Well, what does variable mean?
Variable can change.
Yeah, so will direct material change?
Mm,
Yes, the more we produce, the more we'll have. Yeah, so even if you haven't studied it, you just need to think logically as well in terms of like which costs are fixed. Fixed means they don't change, and which costs are variable, meaning they will change. So materials will change. The more I produce, the more I will pay. So 32 minus, what is it?
6.4.
Okay, that's the first one. Minus, what else do we have?
Direct labor.
How much is that?
850.
Okay, what else? Anything
variable
else?
Variable factory overheads and variable selling and administration overheads.
Yeah, so minus 3 and minus, what's the last one? 2.5.
Yeah.
Okay, close brackets equals.
Sorry, can I see?
Let's copy that working and then let's paste it here. Equals paste. That's the amount. That'll be units. Yeah, so 5 times 18 plus 3.5 times 18, all divided by 32 minus, 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 minus. Okay, so this would be the break even point in units. Right, so if I had to interpret that, this particular business would have to sell 13,304 units to cover all their costs. That's what you're basically saying. Their fixed costs. Taking their selling price minus variable cost into consideration. Right, that's break-even point. So do they want break-even point in units or in dollars?
Just calculate in units.
In units. Okay, then that's fine. Then you would stop there. If they wanted this in dollars or revenue, then you'd have to multiply this by the selling price, the 32. Okay, they asked that in the assignment. They said calculate break-even point in revenue.
Okay.
B.
Calculate break-even points as a percentage of capacity.
Okay, so the BEP in units is 13,300. And would I use 304 or would I use 305?
Pardon?
Would I use 304 or 305?
What do you mean?
How would I round this off?
Oh, because you're talking about 304, that's why I was confused. So it would be 305.
Yes, that's right. Why? I can't have a third of a unit, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so just remember when we did break even, we have to always round up. Okay, because in order to break even, I have to sell that fifth unit. Bless you. I have to sell that fifth unit. If I don't sell that fifth unit, I'm going to be short. If I sell 3304 units, I'm a little bit short of break even. Okay, meaning I haven't broken even yet.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the first part. What is the capacity? Let's check. The question spoke about it.
The budget output is that which represents 75% of total production capacity.
Okay, so 18,000 units is only 75% of capacity. So if 18,000 units is 75% of capacity, what is 100% capacity? Because that's what they said here, percentage of capacity. Right, so 18,000 equals 0.75 capacity. Okay, so what do I do? 18,000 divided by 0.75 equals capacity. Right, let's solve. 18,000 divide 0.75 equals 24,000. That's total capacity. Right, so they said calculate the break even point as a percentage of capacity. So if it's a percentage, it's numerator over denominator. So to answer the question, BEP as a percentage of capacity equals. What was our BEP? 13305 divided by, what is our capacity? 24,000 equals. Let's see. 13305 divided by 24,000. times 100 to get a percentage, hey? That percent. Right, so the final answer would be 55.4075. You could probably round it off if you wanted to, but then just indicate round off to the nearest two decimals or three decimals. Now, these are nice, short, simple, easy little questions. I mean, 4 marks with a 4, no, there's 3. 3 marks, 5 marks, they're quite easy to do. All it requires is just a formula and then understanding interpretation. Okay. Right, complete. Next. That was B, C.
Prepare marginal cost statement to show only limited budgeted total profit for the year ending 30th of June 2014 based on budget output of 18,000.
Okay, so remember marginal means the next. So I'm going to sell the next item. Just to get the format. Okay, I didn't have the text when I did that assignment. Okay, so my format might have been a little bit different. We can adapt it here in case, but I did the workings for it though. So just check what the format is, because they can be quite particular when it comes to that. Let's just find it first. Okay, so marginal costing, 301. Yes. Okay, so with marginal costing, they want the marginal statement. Do they want cost or revenue? What did they want? Marginal cost. There's it. Okay. Yeah, so what I did when I did the assignment is I just grouped it. Revenue together, expenses together, and then cost together. That's what I did to get the profit. Okay, so to stick to this format, I'm just going to use page 303. Marginal cost statement format. Okay, so the format is 2 columns. We need revenue less variable costs, and then skip a few lines, total contribution, then what? Less fixed costs. And then skip a few lines, profit for the year. Right, so that's the format from page 303 in the textbook. I'm going to use 2 columns, the same as what they've done. So 1 column for the workings, 1 column for the final answers. And that's what we're doing
here. They gave additional information under.
Yeah, we need additional information.
For the next question? Yeah, I think that's for the
possibly. Let's see what we've got to start with. We need something to work with. We probably need that. Yeah, grab that page. Because this was all question 3. We're just continuing with the workings. Right, so they said prepare the marginal cost statement to show A Limited's budgeted total profit for the year. Okay, so this is budgeted. So budgeted is based on how many units? We saw it earlier. 18,000 units. Okay, that's budgeted. They said for the year ended June 2014 based on the budgeted output. See, they said, they even said it there as well. It came from here. Okay, so it's fine. Right, revenue. How much are we selling those 18,000 units at? This column. Totals go in that column, 18,000 times, 32. Okay, in terms of the templates, we start with direct materials. Do they give you direct materials in this question?
Pardon?
Do they give you direct materials in this question?
Yeah, but.
What? Okay. Right? But what's wrong?
No, go. I want to see what you're going to
do. Direct.
This is like a working.
Materials. Okay, how much were the direct materials? 6 rand 50 per unit. So, open brackets, 650 times 18,000 units. Was there any direct wages in this question?
Because it's done direct materials. Yeah, there was 850.
Yes, what for this direct labor. Yeah, labor wages, same thing, just different word. Direct wages. Let's use the same thing as they've used. Well, let's use what they've given in the question, actually. That would be better. The textbook uses wages. Direct labor. Same thing applies. Show the working 18,000 units times 850 gives us 1,000,000. Okay, next one. Factory expenses. Were there any factory expenses here?
Yeah, 3.
Variable factory expenses? 3. Good. So 3 times 18. 18. Factory overheads. I'm using the same words as the question. 18,000 times 3. Okay, next one. Were there any selling and distribution expenses?
Yeah, more selling and admin.
Yeah, selling admin. Okay, so see, the textbook showed selling and distribution together. In this example, they had selling and admin together. It doesn't matter. They're still variable expenses. Put it in. Okay, so selling and admin. That's what they used here in the exam. Selling and admin. Bracket. 18,000 times... what was its cost? 250. Okay, was that it? Yes, we've covered all of that. To get the contribution, I need the total variable cost. So sum up all of the variable costs, get a total. There's the total. The contribution will be the revenue minus the costs, gives you the total contribution.
369. What does total contribution mean?
The contribution is just your selling price, your selling your revenue minus your variable costs. Contribution. Contribution is how much is that, how much is the sale generating for the business?
So that should be in brackets. So
yeah, this would be negative. Yeah, negative. I'm just going to put in red. Okay, you can show brackets.
But what does contribution mean?
How much you're generating from the sale after having taken into consideration the direct material. Right, so in other words, okay. So labor. Okay, so if you're selling, let's say your service. Okay, whatever the cost is for your service... right, you need to pay the lady to work, and you need to pay for the direct material. So total contribution is the difference. Okay, what you're getting from the customer minus what you're having to pay to do the job. Fixed costs? Do we have factory overheads,
yeah.
Selling overheads, fixed? Yeah, we've got two, hey?
Mm-hmm.
Let's put them both in here.
I think I'm going to have space because I've only got two lines left.
You have to add your own lines then, yeah.
Should I just put these in one thing?
No, you shouldn't put it as one.
Factory and selling.
No, you need to keep it separate. Yeah, so two separate lines.
Okay, so less fixed costs.
Yeah, that's not good if they're not giving you enough lines. That's not a good thing. Okay. What were we doing? Fixed factory overhead. That was the first one. Okay, the fixed factory overheads, how much was it? $5. So 5 times 5. 18 times 5. 18,000 times 5. 90,000. And the other one? There was only two here, hey? Selling and admin. And this one was? Variable selling and admin overheads, 2.5. No, wrong one. 3.5. Okay, 3.5. Right, copy paste, 3.5. 3.5. That's it. Okay, so the fix this plus that. Those two added together, that'll be in brackets again, it's a negative. And then just subtract. 207 minus 53, answer 54. The end.
Now, so simple, is the point of this to get profit for the year?
Yes, okay, but remember these are marginal cost statements. So these cost statements are based on what you predict you are going to have to incur as a business when operating. Okay, remember it's based on budgeted, so it's what we believe will happen in the future.
So this is just like a...
It's management accounting.
Like a prediction.
Yes, it's management accounting, it's planning. Okay, so you're planning for the month, you're planning for the year, you're planning for the period. Right, so looking at this, this business would expect to have 54,000 at the end of the year. Okay, remember a budget is what we do before reality takes place, right? So then now the business operates and they have customers. Maybe they have more customers than they expected. Maybe their product is really good. And then they sell more. Then they'll have more direct material, labor, overhead, and so on. Then they do a calculation. And then they'll see, well, were they in line with the budget? Yes or no? Okay, if things are better than budgeted, then that's good. So for example, if the profit came out to more at the end of the year, then that'll be a good sign. So budgeting is just looking at managing the estimated income and expenses. So you have an idea of what's going to happen. Okay, there was additional information, but you said that related to the next question, right?
Well, I think.
Okay, let's read it and see now.
Okay, just wait.
Now, remember, management is detailed, financial is summarized. Okay, the investors wouldn't care really how much cost you're actually incurring. They just want to know how much profit the business is making.
Calculate the revised break-even points in the
Okay, based on what?
Probably this.
Let's see. Yeah, I'm not too sure. Does this information relate to this question or relate to that question? See, it's a little bit like, it could be related to this. This was out of what, 5 marks? This was out of what, 3 marks? Okay, so I do think that's the case. They should have like underlined or like said the end and then start the new one. Because see, question C is here and then under question C, they've actually given you additional information. Do you see
that's
that?
How they did it in the summer. Yeah. They gave additional information and then required. Do you know what I'm saying? And they probably ran out of space, so it's required on the next page.
Yeah. Okay. Well, let's just do it that way. So the next question is out of more marks. So then I would say, so asterisk here, okay, we will use the additional info for this question. Okay, if we were supposed to use it for the other one, then all of it would have to change, obviously. Okay, but that's what we're assuming here. Okay, using the additional information for the next question. But what if the next question wants?
The revised break-even point.
Okay, so let's copy-paste the formula. The formula doesn't change. That'll stay the same. Copy. Paste. Okay, this is D. Okay, so taking the additional information into consideration, let's revise the BEP.
Okay, number one, the directors are considering purchasing an additional machinery at the cost of 45.
Okay, keep going. Next.
So does that, is not that not going to affect him?
That would be CapEx, capital expenditure. So buying more equipment. Would that be a fixed cost? No. Would that be a selling price? No. Variable cost? Maybe, depending on how we operate. Okay.
This will increase capacity by 10%.
Okay, that's important.
But we don't need that now.
We do. It's revised break-even point. Okay, so what is the current capacity? Current capacity is what? What did we read earlier? How much does this business sell or produce?
18,000.
Yes, 18,000. Okay, they will add 10% because of this new machine. Right, so having read the addition information, they're telling us that this will increase capacity by 10%. So if I'm increasing capacity by 10%, what am I going to be doing? Well, the new production will be 18,000 times 1,10 equals 18,000 times 1.1 is adding 10%. Did you get that? Same answer. Good. Next.
Machinery will be written off over 5 years with an estimated residual value of 5,000.
Okay, that's looking at depreciation. Would depreciation be part of the cash, the break-even point? No, the depreciation is a non-cash item.
The directors plan to reduce the selling price by 12.5%, and this will increase demand by 50%.
Okay, that's quite a bit. So let's look at the first part. Reduction in selling price. Okay, so old price. What is the old price? 32. New price. Is the new price going up or down? Reduce by 12.5%. Okay, so 32 times 0.875. What did you get? 28 is correct. That's the new price. Okay, let's read the second part.
Fixed and selling admin overhead.
No, hold on. We haven't read the...
And this will increase demand by 50%.
Okay, so demand will increase by 50%. Okay, so if demand is going to increase by 50%, this 19,800 is going to be multiplied by 1.5, increased by 50%.
What is 19,800?
The capacity, the production.
But that's just demand. Is that what you have to do?
Well, I'm looking at how much will you sell, so how much are we going to sell? At the beginning, they said, see here, budgeted output is 18,000 units. They didn't say how much we were going to sell. So I'm assuming what you produce is what you sell, right? Yeah, so if they're saying the demand is going to increase, that's my assumption. My assumption would be you would increase the demand, so more people would buy. If they told you how much you were selling, then you could do a separate calculation.
5 times 1.5?
Making increase by 50%.
Okay, so it would just be times 50%.
$29,700. Okay. And then the last bullet said what?
Fixed and selling admin overheads will increase by 10%.
Okay, so fixed selling and so we do need fixed costs. So fixed costs brackets, let's just define them. This was the selling and admin, hey? Okay, so what was the old fixed cost for selling and admin? We need to go back and check. Fixed cost for selling and admin. There, fixed cost, selling and admin, 63,000. See that? Okay, so it was 63,000. The new fixed cost and selling would be what? An additional 10%. So this times 1.1 at 10% gives me that. So that would be the new fixed cost for admin and selling. Right, so let's copy paste our, that obviously goes because it's from the previous exercise. Copy this. Let's fill in all the amounts now. Okay, so what are our fixed costs? Brackets. We need to put all of them in. So let's take it from here. There, factory overheads, 90,000. And then the selling and admin will change. It's not going to be 63,000, it will be something different. Okay, so we can even write this down. It'll be, oh, this will change though. It'll be 5 times, not 18,000. It'll be 5 times 29,000. Okay, so 5 times 29,700.
Is this at the top?
Hey?
Is this the fixed costs?
Yes, it's at the top, numerator. Plus, then the new fixed cost selling and admin was 693,000, close brackets, divide, open brackets. The new price is 28. 28 minus, okay, all the other ones stay the same. Okay, what were the variable costs? 6.5 minus, what is the other one? 8.5.
So now this is the denominator.
Yes, minus variable factory overheads, 3, minus variable selling and admin, 2.5, close brackets. Okay, and then we need to type all of that in. Right, 29,040 units. That's the new break-even point. Okay, so having taken all those adjusted bullets, points, considerations into consideration, you have a break-even point which has been revised. The break-even point now is 29,040 units. So in order to break even now, I have to sell more. And that would make sense, because what did it do to your price? You dropped your price. Your price was 32. Now your price is 28. So logically, we would expect the break-even point to increase, meaning we would have to sell more.
Okay.
E.
Now let's revise the capacity.
Okay, so calculate the revised break-even point as a percentage of capacity. Okay, so same as before. Obviously, BEP, or let's write down the word revised. Revised BEP is our answer, 29040. Okay, we need to revise the capacity. Okay, so earlier on, we saw that the capacity was, so what was the old capacity? 18,000, that's what we had here. Let's copy all this. Okay, copy paste. Okay, so this is literally what you did previously. 18,000 was 75% capacity. Then we calculated the 24,000. Right, this will increase by 10%, right? Just go back to the addition information. Capacity increased by 10%. That's fine. Okay, and then we had the right answer. We had the 24,000 times 1,1, increased by 10%. So 26,400 is the new capacity.
So is that the final?
No, not yet. It's a percentage of. Calculate the revised break-even point as a percentage of. So now we can write down that. Let's just use that heading. Where is it? The break-even point as a percentage of capacity equals the BEP 29040 divided by 26 400 times 100 to get a percentage. Right, so that would be break-even point as a percentage of capacity. Right, so you would actually need to be producing a little bit more than your current capacity in order to break even, right, because there was a reduction in the selling price. And that makes sense, because if I lower my price, I would be expected to sell more. If I'm selling more, I'm going to have to produce more in order to meet the break-even points. Yeah, so it's not always a good thing to raise prices or to lower prices. If you lower prices too much, it creates a problem for the business, because the business needs to operate and meet the demand. Okay.
Yeah, it's the same. So prepare a marginal cost statement to show Ali's limited revised total profit for the year.
Okay, so we're doing the exact same thing. Copy paste this, we just need to adapt it. Okay. This is question F. Right, so I literally copy-pasted what we had earlier. Just some of these things we need to change. So revenue, we need to change. Right, in terms of sales, we had that earlier. Let's go find it. Where's our units? Selling units. Where's our selling units? Demand. Where was the demand increased by 50%? Yeah, this one. The new price. See, 28. 28 is the new price times 29,700. Okay, so 29,700 times 28 rand, $28. $28. $29,700 times 28. Right, so revised revenue, there's the new figure. Okay, these costs are going to stay the same as is, just the demand will change. So 29,700. Direct labor, 29,700. $29,700. We just need to check the material cost didn't change, eh?
If I remember correctly. Do you have two factory overheads?
The one is variable and the one is fixed. Where's the question? Here's it, take the addition information. No. I think you've got it. It's on the back of that page.
These are all the new amounts now.
No, they're not. I need that other page.
Okay, sorry.
Okay, first one. What was the first one representing? Additional?
Machinery.
Okay, would that affect this? No, it wouldn't, because that's depreciation. Okay, so the directors are considering purchasing additional machinery. The additional machinery would be a once-off cost. That wouldn't have been fixed or variable. The depreciation would be a non-cash item, so that wouldn't affect this, actually.
So this is not fixed or variable?
It's a once-off cost. Okay, because you only buy machinery once. Okay, unless you are paying this over time as an installment. See, that's different. Okay, but we can't use that. I just want to check, did these ones stay the same or did they change? Number two, capacity, we did increase. The machinery, that's fine, that's the depreciation. Number four, we reduced the price, we increased the demand. Okay, so the only one that changed was number five, fixed selling and admin. So all of these other amounts are going to stay as is, except I just need to update the amounts. Okay, so this will be 29,700 times 6.5. Okay, that's the new amounts. 29,700, that's the new amounts. 29,700, that's the new amounts. 29,700, that's the new amount. Okay, so based on the new revised demand in terms of sales, the variable cost total 608,850. Okay, then contribution, that'll be this minus that, that's fine. The overheads won't change. 297 times 5, that's right, okay. And the selling and admin will change. That they said changed by 10%. So we had that earlier. This we would delete. And this would have come from our previous question. Where's our previous question? There's it. See? The new fixed cost. That one. Okay, 69,300. 69,300. 69,300. Okay, so yeah, things don't look too good. They look worse than it was before. Right, so reducing your price is not a good thing. Why? Well, for this business, reducing the price lowered their profits. Not ideal. It lowered the profit. They still make a profit, but not enough. So now, do you want to sell more and make a smaller profit, or do you want to sell less and make a bigger profit? See, it's about that price. Okay, the biggest consideration here was the change in price. They changed the price from R32 or $32 to $28. And that obviously affected the profit for the year.
So the last question just says, advise the directors whether they should go ahead with their plans. Give a reason for your answer.
Okay, so should they?
So I believe that the directors should not.
Wow, 7 marks.
I believe that the directors should not go ahead with their plans as their profit will decrease from 54 to 4950.
Okay, that's not enough for 7 marks.
Yeah, I'm asking you what Martin said.
Well, what is that going to do to production? Increase or decrease it?
Increase.
Yes. Okay. So if you lower the price, did you mention anything about the price? No, you just talked about the profits.
Okay. So if.
Yeah. So number one,
price.
They should not do it because of what you just said. Profit decreases. Yeah, the reduction in selling price increases demand for goods.
So if the price is lowered, the demand will increase.
Correct. So they have to produce more. More production required. More resources, more labor, more overheads, more expenses, basically.
So they will have to produce more. Yeah.
What else?
Let's look at before and after. Okay, before we had this. Right, so did the revenue go up? Yes. Did the variable cost go up? Yes. Did the fixed cost go up? Yes. What happened to the contribution? Have a look. It's 207. Here it's 2,227.50. So the contribution increases, but this does not offset the additional costs. Okay, meaning it's not worthwhile producing more quantity. Right, if I'm going to produce more quantity to sell more, it's going to add more cost to the business's operations. Right, they're selling more volume, but they're not selling at a higher profit. Okay, so that's another consideration, is the contribution is affected. The contribution increases, but not enough to offset the additional costs. Something else you could maybe say, you could talk about the production cost increasing. So production costs increase, that's also bad. Okay, because when we look at the additional information,
I said this will increase variable and fixed costs, reducing the profit. It is therefore not worthwhile to produce more.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's think of others. Wow, 7 marks are the largest for. Let's think. What else could you say? Normally, I would use this as a guide. I would use the information here. Here's it. Okay, so I would try use this to explain that. Capacity. They had to buy more machinery. That you could even add as well. You could say if this had to be implemented. If this is implemented. Comma, there will be additional once-off costs of buying machinery to add capacity. Right, so now does the business want to actually go and invest more capital to increase the capacity so they can produce more? And they're producing more, but they're still making less profits. So that's another additional thing. See, that we can mention because that came from the question. But I would be using that to describe here because so far we haven't spoken about that. So because this is 7 marks, I do think you could talk quite a bit about the additional machinery. The capacity we spoke about, the machinery we spoke about, reduction in price we spoke about, the demand, you could maybe talk about some economics. You could say lowering prices increases demand. Okay, so it puts more pressure on the business. And then the last one was just increasing in fixed admin. And then you can maybe use that straight from the question, fixed admin and selling increases. Just to try and make up more points for 7 marks. Okay, it's a lot just for a theory question. Wow. I mean, you get 3 marks for drawing up that table. You get 7 marks for interpreting it. So it's a lot, but that's good because interpretation shouldn't be too bad. But strategy, go and look back at the question and see if you can come up with more. Is that the end?
Yeah, that's the end.
Okay, good. So do you think you can manage one on your own and then hand it in to me? The first, I think you did 2 questions on your own, right?
Yeah.
Those 2 went quickly. You saw that took us like 10 minutes. Why? You didn't have to write anything down. It was just checking and just seeing if you understood everything and changing one or 2 things. Right, so if you can do that again, that's brilliant, right, because it goes quicker.
Yeah.
To go through everything with you takes a little bit longer.
Yeah, I just wanted to go through this stuff with you because this stuff is the
No problem.
That's why I I went through it, but I thought it was easier together.
No problem. Obviously, it'll get better, quicker, easier with more practice. Yeah. So, if you can maybe do another one by Friday.
Yeah.
Okay, because Wednesday we'll do this, but with maths.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll show you, I'll do it, we can discuss it, we can revise. Then you can do a maths paper for next week.
Next week.
All right, so this week, we've done the counting, try to do a past paper on your own for Friday.
Okay.
And then let's see how it goes. We can do the same thing. The stuff that you've done, we can go through it quickly. The stuff that you're struggling with, we can take more time.
Okay.